Married at First Sight season 14, episode 7. And this is the after party, y'all. And in this after party, it was Katina, Michael, and Mark the Shark. So it opened up with Keisha Knight Pulliam asking Michael about this little lie he told about not revealing that he actually had not one but two female roommates. And Michael starts saying, oh yeah, well, what I meant was I didn't have a roommate, and which was my spouse. Boy, bye. No. Just say you lied. Just say you lied and tell us the reason why you lied. I know why you lied, because you didn't want to upset her and you didn't want to give her no more ammunition because she didn't like any of the other stuff you was telling her. So why tell her this part too? I know why he lied, because just like he said, the lie didn't serve no purpose. It's not like she would have known. It wasn't like, no, it wasn't saving them for anything. So I know why he lied, because he didn't know how she was going to take it. And so he decided to keep it to himself. And he basically said it was a bad judgment call. But he definitely lied. Sometimes the lies are worse than the truth. Sometimes it's better just to tell the truth and take whatever consequences can come, as opposed to telling a lie and being caught in the lie, because that's what happened to Michael. Then Martha Shark started telling his story about the bed bugs, which, you know what? He's telling half the story too. So anyway, he tells the story that 2 days before the wedding is when he found out he had bed bugs. So then what he did was, 2 days before the wedding, he starts trying to move out his stuff or some of his stuff out the apartment, because he knows he's getting married in 2 days. Plus, he's not going to be coming back to the apartment. So, of course, he doesn't get everything out the apartment. He only gets he gets like a couch out, and I guess the bed out, places where the bed bugs are probably really living. And he decides to go on off and get married at the wedding. Well, his landlord is at the wedding too. So it's not that she didn't like Mark or she was mad at Mark, because she was at the wedding too. But I think what started to happen was she started to realize, wait a minute. So you get married, you're going to go off, you're not coming back, and you left this apartment with a bunch of stuff in it, and you got bed bugs. Well, who's going to take care of this? Then she figures out that he married Lindsay, and Lindsay has two more cats than the three cats he already has. So that's five cats. So you got a landlord who's dealing with bed bugs, you about to leave, and you think you're going to come back and bring two more cats in the apartment? Hell no, I'm with that landlord. You need to resolve this issue. And maybe people thought, you know, she shouldn't have been blown up on vacation. Well, he should have put somebody else in charge of it while he was gone. Because don't no landlord want to have bed bugs running around in an apartment while you off gallivanting, getting married, and going to Cancun, and these bed bugs are spreading all through the apartment building. Hell no. I think Mark gave his notice he was moving out before the wedding. I think he figured, hey, I'm going to move out anyway, so I'll just let her know I'm not coming back. Because let me tell you, I don't think any landlord can change the lease in the middle of the lease. He's talking about all of a sudden she was changing the lease. That's probably because it was at the end of the lease. You probably told her you was getting married and you wasn't coming back. And then you tried to stick her with all the work of having to deal with these doggone bed bugs. The work, the expense, the headache, and everything. Don't nobody want to go in no apartment with bed bugs that you've been left behind while you will go off and get married? I'm with Katina. Like Katina said, you're not moving into my house with no bed bugs. You're going to have to get rid of everything. I'm a step further, Katina. Not only are you not bringing nothing in my house with no bed bugs, but you're going to come naked. No clothes on your back. You ain't bringing nothing in the house. Anyway, Keisha Knight Pulliam starts talking to Michael again about what's going on with all the argument between you and Jasmina. What was it really about? And so he brings up the catamaran again, where you know, supposedly he yelled at her and told her, you cut me off, and the big rigmarole. And, you know, they play the clip and everything. And it's interesting, you know, the clip looked a little different. The clip that was shown originally, like episode a couple ago, it seemed like they left a little more pause in between him talking and she talking. Now, when they played the clip on the after party, it seemed like it was less of a pause. But I still don't think she cut him off, but it definitely was a difference. And I think about it, what it was he didn't fully finish his complete thought. But what he did was he said, well, yeah, we've only known each other for a little while. Wouldn't you say that? And then what he did was he tossed it back to her, and she picked it up and she ran with it, and she finished the complete, she started adding her own thoughts. So maybe he felt like, you know what? She didn't give him enough time to finish his thought. But that ain't the same thing as cutting you off, Michael. So you was wrong. And he admitted it. He said, yeah, you know what? And she didn't cut me off. So he says, I'm Mr. Accountability. I'm willing to take accountability for that. Then they start talking about Katina and Olajuwon, how Olajuwon had told Pastor Cal that the reason why they weren't having sex with me because he was the one that had waited. And Katina was like, that ain't the whole story. We both wanted to wait. It was mutual. He trying to act like it was all him. And like, she's over here trying to jump his bones. And he's like the one saying no. She was like, it was mutual. Then they start talking about who's the most affectionate out of everybody. And they said the most affectionate was, Mark and Lindsay, because they're always holding hands and hugging and everything. So they said about all the couples, they're the most affectionate. But then, you know, Mark drops the bombshell and says, you know, when Mark and Lindsay were doing all this fighting before Pastor Cal, he basically says they hadn't even slept in the same bed the night before. Mark's little something down below it. It ain't in the game. He's obviously telling. And he said, you know what? They had sex 2.5 times. Keisha Knight pulling was like, wait a minute. How can you have sex 2.5 times? Because what Mark basically said is we had sex twice. And then what ended up happening was the third time he didn't really want to have sex. So I guess it involves some sort of masturbation or something or another, because basically he said, I just sat there and watched her. So I guess that causes for half the time. So Lindsay's probably was getting a little sexually frustrated because Mark is checking out. He's like, his head ain't in the game. And when I say his head ain't in the game, I'm talking about the little head. Not just the big head, but the little one too. I was glad to see Katina finally speak up about Alyssa. I think now that she's had to see more footage of Alyssa, she's starting to say, you know what? Alyssa has handled a lot of situations poorly. Now, I know the ladies like to stick together historically and the men like to stick together historically, but I think Katina, you know, Katina sometimes to me is she can shift through all the bullshit, and she's starting to see that although Alyssa may be a nice person, you know, to her, she's starting to see that Alyssa doesn't treat a lot of people nice. So I was glad to see her finally speak up and call Alyssa out on some of her bullshit. You know, all the guys seem to have a nice bromance. All the guys get along really, really well. Michael and Mark are throwing each other compliments back to each other. They're basically praising Chris, how he handled the situation with Alyssa. The guys seem to be on the same page. It's the women that don't get along. That call camaraderie, all that camaraderie around the girls, it ain't the same as with the guys. But that's all that happened on the after party. All right. Talk to y'all later. Bye.